Well, hello again, friends. My name is Reverend Thomas Harper, and I'm the pastor of St. Luke's United Methodist Church in Bryan College Station. And this is Weekly Theistic Reflections, where each week I take a verse of Scripture and I talk about it a little bit. I've entitled this episode, How We Lose Matters. Scripture that I picked for today is James 4:14. Yet you do not know what tomorrow will bring. What is your life? For you are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. So this past fall, I enjoyed incredible success when it comes to sports teams that I support. My two daughters got to see their daddy shout for joy as the Astros made their run through the playoffs and capped it off by winning the World Series. They also got to see their daddy get all excited about TCU football again because they had a remarkable season. They went undefeated in the regular season, they went to the playoffs, beat Michigan, and made it all the way to the national championship. My little girls got to see how excited daddy was and how important sports is in his life. The night when the national championship finally arrived, I had my old roommate from college, who's been my best friend and really supports TCU for a long time, with me. I had my wife there with me, who was watching the game, who has been supporting the Horned Frogs all the way back into the Rose Bowl in 2010. And of course, I had my two little girls dressed up with their TCU shirts, ready to go, excited to watch the national championship. Then TCU got destroyed. It was evidence pretty early on that this was not going to go the way we wanted it to. Needless to say, we were all very disappointed that TCU was not even going to come close to winning the national championship on that night. And my daughter knew it. She knew that daddy was upset. She knew that this game wasn't going the way we wanted it to. But she was crying in her bed because she wanted to experience this important moment with her dad. And I thought to myself, I have an opportunity to teach my daughter what it means to lose. That she had recognized over the course of these months how much dad got excited and passionate about his sports. And now she's watching me to see how I will respond when my team loses. I said, okay, baby. I grabbed her, I pulled her out of bed, and we sat and watched the rest of the half of the national championship game. And it wasn't pretty. It wasn't fun, it didn't look good, but we experienced the loss together. We went through this all-important sporting event as daddy and daughter. I had the opportunity to teach her what it means to lose well, what it means to lose with character, with respect, to teach good sportsmanship, and also just that sports is only that, it's just sports. We actually have no control over how good the teams that we support is. Life goes on. And even in life, there will be times when you lose. And how you lose, how you conduct yourself after losing matters. And I had an opportunity to teach my daughter that. And so yeah, I was mad at the game. I was mad that we lost, especially in the way that we lost. But I got to teach my child how to lose. Spending that moment with her as daddy and daughter. And that was more important on that night than sports. Here's a question that I want you to ponder. In life, how we lose is at least as important as how we win. Why do you think that that's the case? While you're here, I invite you to check out this video. It's another kind of sports video. It's called Change the Ending. And it's around the Astros' massive comeback a couple years ago, late in the first half of the baseball season against the New York Yankees, and how they snatched victory from the jaws of defeat. And how that can relate to our life. That we can be going one way in life, down a bad path, and yet, through the grace and mercy of God, we can change our ending. And so if you're interested in more on that topic, I invite you to check out that video. If you're in the Bryan College Station area, I invite you to check us out. We have a worship service every single Sunday morning at 10 a.m. We also live stream right here via Facebook so you get an idea of past services and what we're about. But if you're in the area, I'd love to get to know you. I'd love to do life and ministry with you. But until next time, friends, know that you're going to lose sometimes in life. And sometimes things are not going to go the way that you wanted them to go. But know that how you lose matters. Know that your children are watching how you lose. And be sure that you teach them that there is more to life than sports, and that in life, it's not just how much you win, but how you lose. Until next time, friends, continue to love each other well. Take care.